that we limit ourselves to the four corners of the sworn statement plus other matters that arose from this hearing. More importantly, more pointedly, the claim of former administrator Si Rafica. And we're now shifting to, with the permission of Senator Pimentel, we're now shifting to item 3. That there was the claim of Mr. Si Rafica is that it was not 300,000 but 600,000. Mr. Si Rafica, are you still online? Are you still there?
Yes, Mr. Chair.
I even asked you, bakit ngayon lang lumabas yung 600,000 na hindi mo pinagpapawisan ngayon? Hindi ko alam kung walang aircon dyan sa likod mo. 600,000, tapos sinabi mo online. Ngayon, sinasabi mo, hindi mo sinabi yon. We can replay that.
Hindi ko po sinabi nga 600 po yung sinabi mo yon,
Mr. Chair.
Ang dami nakarinig nung kanina. It's not me against you. Even the media can show that. Ipi-play sa'yo yun. You mentioned 600,000 metric tons. Saan mo nabunot yon? Tapos ngayon, dinideny mo na.
Mr. Chair.
Hindi ko po yung sinabi, Mr. Chair.
Kung nandito ka lang sa premises ng Senado, pinakulong ka na namin dito. Pero sinabi mo yung kanina, ang pinalalabas mo ngayon, ako yung nagsisinungaling.
Hindi po ganyan yung pagsabi ko farmers ng kanilang pag-accept ng Keynes at saka...
Mr. Chairman, po yun, I even commented, ngayon ko lang narinig yung 600,000 metric tons, ngayon ko lang narinig yung online, ang sinabi ko pa, wag mong gamitin yung Pangulo. Sinabi mo, sumagot ka uli. Sabi mo, 600,000 metric tons. Now you are denying that and impliedly saying that either we are deaf here, all of us here are deaf, or I am lying.
Yung 600,000 po yan, Mr. Chair, hindi po yan galing sa akin po. Yung 600,000 na yan, hindi galing po yan sa akin. Yung binanggit po ni Presidente ng 600,000, sabi ko po na Mr. President, that might be too much. Yun ang sabi ko po.
What you're saying now is that it never came from you, but from another source, the chief executive himself. Perhaps the good executive secretary can affirm whether that came from the president himself or Mr. Si Rafica is telling us false truths, half lies, or what? Executive Secretary, have the floor.
Thank you, Mr. Chairman. Wala hong binabanggit na amount in terms of quantity si kagalang-galang na Pangulo Ferdinand Bongbong Marcos Jr. pagdating doon sa metric tons na dapat iangkat. Kaya po tayo naipit doon sa import plan pa lamang dahil hindi nga ho kami kumbinsido sa 300,000 metric tons. Again, let me be very clear, Your Honors, wala hong debate na dapat tayo ay mag-angkat. Wala pong debate na dapat tayo mag-import. Nahinto na lamang po kami kung magkakano talaga yung amount na dapat nating iangkat. At wala pong katotohanan na nanggaling kay Pangulong Marcos yung 600,000 metric tons. I would like to join the manifestation of the good senator, the Senate President, kung yung 300,000 metric tons nga ho ay hindi kumbinsido ang Pangulo, bakit naman niya sasabihin 600,000 metric tons? And fact of the matter, Your Honors, there is already a 150,000 metric tons. Malayong-malayo po doon sa sinabi kanina ng dating SRA administrator na 600,000 metric tons.
I'd just like to add, Mr. Chairman, sa ilang hearing na po ito, pangatlong hearing na po ito, bakit na yun lang niya binanggit yun? Dapat sa naunang hearing pa lang, binanggit niya na yun. Where is this supposed number come from and where is it coming from? Dudang-duda ako dito, Mr. Chairman. I don't know why this kind of information was put in play, maybe to muddle all these discussions. But why did he just come up with this now and now he's denying it?
Mr. Chair?
Senator Ontiveros, is this related to... Go ahead.
Thank you, Mr. Chair. Someone is about to be cited in contempt, but there is a recording of the Zoom meeting, and that recording can put these issues to rest. So siguro, Mr. Chair, kahit si Chair lang po ay makapanood noon or at least makatanggap ng transcript nung meeting na yon, to set these issues to rest. That would be the only way to validate. Kung meron silang babanggitin, hindi iuutos, kundi babanggitin or naiisip na 600,000. Marami pong stakeholders sa industry at sa buong bansa natin na maaring dumulog kay Presidente with this or that proposal, this or that amount. Ang importante para sa akin ay kung nabanggit man ni Presidente na it was in his mind at all, kailangan ba ng 600,000, yung sinabi pareho ni dating Administrator Serafica at dating Board Member Valderrama, or ni Mr. Serafica rather, kinonfirm ni dating Board Member Valderrama na masyadong malaki iyon. And klaro, pati dun sa sinabi ni ES na ang pinadraft nilang sugar importation plan or program or order ay for 300,000 lang. So, kaya po, Mr. Chair, napaka-importante nung August 4 meeting na iyon na kahit si Chair na lang ang makapanood or makabasa ng record nung meeting na iyon to set these issues to rest at para klaro kung papaano na set originally yung proposal at 300,000, eventually naging 150,000 ngayon. And if at any time, any stakeholder appeal to the President for an amount of 600,000, there's no crime in that. Gusto lang natin sa komite kumpletuhin yung kwentong ito. And Chair, I'm sorry, I need to pull out at this point. I apologize to the Chair and to SP and my colleagues, to the ES and all of our resource persons, including Yusek Sebastian and Administrator Serafica and Board Member Valderrama. I have a victim survivor of sexual abuse, sexual violence waiting for me in another committee.
The committee knows marami pong salamat, Mr. Chair. Senator Antiveros, but the Chair is now constrained. Secretary. Mr. Ramata, you stated under oath that the claim of Mr. Serafica relative to the 300,000 metric ton was pre-approved, and you rebutted this a while ago. Can you repeat that for the benefit of some of our colleagues who just arrived? Yung section number 29 of the supplemental affidavit of Mr. Serafica that was just executed to September 2022. Mr. Serafica claimed that there is no truth to the allegation of you, Mr. Lamata, that it was made to appear that the 300,000 metric tons was already approved by the President. Can you repeat what you said 30 minutes ago?
Again, good afternoon to this honorable court. committee pa. During those times when the sugar prices in the retail stores were very high.
No. What I'm saying is this. Yung sinabi ba ni Mr. Serafica dito na sinasabing nagsisinungaling ka ay tama o mali? Sino ang nagsisinungaling?
Siya ang sinungaling po. Serafica. He is a liar.
Because of?
There's no truth to whatever he said. There is no shortage. It's number one.
Mali.
Ay, mali yun.
Because?
Because there's no truth to it. There's no truth to it, Mr. Senator.
Thank you, Mr.
Namin salamat.
We now recognize Attorney Victor Rodriguez, the Executive Secretary.
Thank you, Mr. Chairman. Just to be clear, Mr. Chairman, if the alleged Zoom or video meeting took place, and if I get the date correctly mentioned by the Honorable Senator Risa Ontiveros, was August 4, let it be put on record, Mr. Chairman. Nung August 4 po, wala po kaming Zoom meeting ni Mr. Serafica. He was in my office, Your Honors. He was physically present in my office, and that is contained in my statement during my first appearance in this Honorable Blue Ribbon Committee. He was in my office and we were discussing precisely if he could liquidate the 200,000 metric tons product of SO3. Nandoon po siya sa aking tanggapan at yun din po yung aking statement na ang kaharap po niya ay ang aking Senior Deputy Executive Secretary, ang aking Deputy Executive Secretary for Legal, at ang aking Deputy Executive Secretary for Finance, at nandun din ho yung Pangulo ng PITC na si Dr. Molly Chong. I would just want to make this clear because the name of the President is unnecessarily being dragged by the former SRA Administrator. And as the Executive Secretary, I will not allow that, Your Honors, please.
So, to repeat this, to clarify this once and for all, there was no Zoom online meeting on 4 August 2022, as claimed by Mr. Serafica. Yes? Wala nangyaring ganon?
It cannot be, Your Honor, because he was in my office. But I'm sure that August 4, he was in my office. Yes, after lunch, because it's in my notebook, Your Honor. I'm in the habit of taking notes of all that's happening in my presence. In fact, Your Honor, one of the subject matter that I've raised then, as of 1:30 p.m., August 4, he was seated in front of me, the former SRA administrator. I told him, how come last July 24, there are confusing figures posted on your SRA website. Sabi doon sa website mo, meron ka pang 160,992 metric tons of raw sugar and for domestic production. And also on the same day, July 24, napansin ka ako ng mga staff ko, meron ka na namang 195,025 metric tons ng refined sugar. Nandoon ho kami, nandoon po siya sa aking tanggapan.
So, thank you, Mr. Executive Secretary. Are there questions from the Blue Ribbon? Senator Pimentel, the
Thank you. Thank you, Mr. Chairman. Just to clarify nga the August 4 kasi, kawawa naman yung mga tao, tinawag nyo na illegal, unauthorized, immoral. Kayo, meron bang others present online? Tandaan po natin, Valderrama, Mr. Valderrama confirms such a meeting.
That is what I will have to check, Your Honor, so that we will be precise. What I'm saying is, August 4, what I'm affirming now based on my recollection, it really transpired, Your Honor, that he was physically present in my office. Purposely, we were discussing on how...
Okay, yes, kasi para dun lang tayo. So, okay, so you do not recall an August 4 meeting which is hybrid, alam naman natin yung hybrid na may physical and then may naka-online, where the president was online and maybe he mentioned 600,000 metric tons, but hindi ito utos. I mean, pwedeng brainstorming lang ninyo na nabanggit para wala tayong sinasabing nagsisinungaling. Hindi naman ano yun eh. I mean, hindi naman krimen yun na nag-brainstorming po kayo ng figure. At saka from your... From the opening statement kasi of the Executive Secretary, Mr. Chairman, yung mga gusto nilang malaman sa sugar industry, exactly sa gusto natin malaman. Exactly. Gusto niya malaman yung traders, mga volume. Exacto. So, ibig sabihin nun, ano na lang ito rin sa SRA, you are not transparent enough, SRA. Maraming opaque kayo. Hindi kayo naiintindihan. Maraming gusto namin maintindihan ng inyong mga proseso. So try your best to be transparent. So balik po ako, yes, yun lang po yun. Yun lang po yun para kawawa naman yung mga tao. Tatawagin na natin sinungaling pa. I mean, nabanggit ba ni Presidente Marcos yung 600,000 metric tons offhand in as part of the discussion? And then, kasi iba yung date eh. August 4 ito eh. Then subsequently, pwede nyo na... Pwede pa rin sabihin nyo na you found the 300,000 to be too much. Pero subsequently na po yun, mga 1 week later na po yun. So, August 4 lang po tayo nakatingin. So, yes.
Your Honor, makakaasa po kayo. I'll determine whether there was a hybrid or there was participants in the Zoom meeting. At kagaya po ninyo, wala rin ho kaming layunin o pakay na paratangan ng kung sino man at ng kung ano man ang mga pito may participant doon sa via Zoom, malalaman po ninyo.
With the permission of Senator Pimentel, as requested by Senator Antiveros, kung meron transcript, provide na lang sa chairman. But to correct the impression yung word na sinungaling, kaya ako nabanggit yun kanina, kasi sinasabi niya na hindi raw niya sinabi. You were not yet around, Mr.
I was online. I was present online, Chairman.
Ito po, nakalagay. Maliwanag yung I have the transcripts now. The advanced copy of the TSN. And Mr. Serapica mentioned several times the words 600,000
by another person, Mr. Valderrama. Okay, so dalawa ang nagsasabi po nito. Anyway,
Senator Pimentel, with my interjection again, Mr. Valderrama has not yet been put to the witness stand today. The allegation came from Mr. Serapica that Valderrama was part of the loop.